Hello, everybody, and welcome to today's edition of From the Eagle's Nest. We hope that you had a great Memorial Day and are ready for the start of a beautiful week. Yellowhammer, how about our Tuesday morning warm up?
To warm up, we are going to thank someone very special from our middle school, someone that has served in the Air Force. So thank you to our Master Sergeant, Mr. Wyand. All right. To him. He's done a couple of tours, I believe, Afghanistan. So we want a shout out to that because that's very special. And we appreciate the sacrifice for leaving his family. And of course, we're always thinking of Devin Snyder and her family during these Memorial Days and all those that have passed on in our towns, in our district. So we want to say a special thank you one more time. Thank you, Mr. Wyand. Master Sergeant, very impressive, by the way. Yes. So last week we did a little shout out. We were looking for photos from our communities of patriotic, patriotic pets. She likes this part. And so we have a few that Waxwing and Hawkeye. What can you tell us about our entries?
Oh, we had a lot of great entries, and some kids could get their pets dressed up, some just could not. So we have some that, they might not look patriotic, but they really are at heart. So we have to keep that in mind. We also had some great teacher entries, and we narrowed it down, and we have two great images for you about to come up, and we thank you, teachers, families, and kids, for your photogenic pets.
Sharing some things. You guys shared your photos, but what we want you to do now is share your talents with us. So just check out this information now for the middle school talent show that's coming up, and we can't wait to see the talents that you have for us.
Oh.
And you know, talking about patriotic pets, I thought I'd have a few jokes for you today, too. You know, me and my lovely jokes. So what would you get if you crossed a patriot, a curly-haired dog, a Yankee poodle?
Oh! Very cute!
That's a good one. That's a good one.
And what do you get when you cross a dog and a poach and an egg? No, I gave it away.
I don't know.
Okay, one more. Why did the dog steal the shingles?
I don't know.
He wanted to be a woofer.
Oh, that is great. That is great.
Yeah. Okay, and I'll do a flag one. I'll do a flag one too. What did one flag say to the other?
Don't know.
Waving to you.
Nothing, it just waves. Okay.
Nice.
Enough jokes for now. I'll stop myself. And now we're going to send it to Yellowhammer with her famous bird brain trivia and weather from the nest. Take it away, Yellowhammer.
Here we are. So I have a little summer trivia. I have a couple of questions. The first little fact that I have is popsicles. Everyone loves popsicles. Mm-hmm. Popsicles were first made by mistake. In 1905, a young boy sets a beverage outside, and then the next morning, it was frozen, so we started licking it. Yeah, so we liked that. And then he started selling them at local fairs. So that was the invention of the popsicle.
Thank you for inventing that.
Here we go. Okay, so here's ice cream. What was the first ice cream flavor?
Oh, I know.
A, mint chocolate chip. B, vanilla. C, chocolate. D, butter pecan.
I think it was chocolate.
Oh. I'm going D, butter pecan for me.
Okay. My birthday boy.
Oh happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Anakin.
Vanilla.
He's betting his favorite kind, vanilla.
I'm with him. Right. Vanilla.
High five.
Is it vanilla?
Yeah. Vanilla.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
Good job, Anakin.
So, and one more.
See you later, Anjean.
See you later, Anjean. What is the oldest beach in America? It's not a joke. It's just trivia.
I was going to say, this is a joke. Okay.
Virginia Beach.
Coney Island? Is that a beach?
Further over. Remember the colonies, how everything started?
Not Virginia
Beach. It is. No? Revere Beach in Massachusetts.
I was going to say something in Boston because of the Boston Tea Party. Maybe? I don't know.
Makes sense, huh?
Yeah, there we go. There we go. Too bad we didn't have Mrs. Bowen or Mrs. Willis with us today. I bet she would have gotten that one.
Oh, I bet she would have.
Probably would have.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And weather, our Tuesday, today is Tuesday, and we might be posting this on Wednesday. Our editor is quite busy because he's going to start his own high school show. So if you want to see a high school show, you'd be able to start seeing that. That would be Mr. Miller and Mr. Bongren and Mr. Hartman. And they were inspired by us, ladies.
Oh, they were.
Yes. So if he gets this out, it will be Tuesday. If he doesn't, it will be Wednesday morning. So be looking for us. So weather from the nest. So the Tuesday is going to be hot, real hot and sunny. And then Wednesday and through the week, it's going to be off and on, hot, some thunder showers, and then it's going to cool down just a little bit in the 60s. So take advantage of this heat this couple of days. Make lots of popsicles. Mm-hmm. Make some of those crazy popsicles that you can enjoy. And that's Diglett.
Okay. I call it frizzy hair weather.
Mm-hmm.
Rumor has it Thursday's guest will need no introduction and probably no microphone. I can't wait to see who will grace our nest with presents on Thursday. Do we have any clues, ladies?
Oh, we sure do. And let me tell you, this guest will not need an introduction. Her mouth will give it all away. I love her dearly. She loves to sing and probably talk just as much. Maybe even a little more than I do.
Oh.
There's clue number one. Clue number two, Hawkeye?
This guest loves to boogie. And rumor has it, she can turn any floor into a dance floor, including the classroom. Sorry, kids.
Nice.
Huh. I wonder if it's good dancing or if it's like that cringeworthy dancing.
I think we'll have to take a vote from our viewers.
Excuse me.
Good thing we're social distancing. Sorry.
Third clue is this guest likes to tell stories for anyone who will listen or is willing to listen. But I think she probably tells them even when they're not willing to listen.
And I think her stories go on repeat. You might even hear the same story over and over again. and over and over again. You can even say, hey, I heard that one. She goes, well, I'm going to tell it again.
Yeah. Well, as a teacher, she has a captive audience that can't escape. So it's good. It's good.
It is. It's a very good thing.
Oh, so speaking of jobs, let's go to Akikiki and Koyak for Birds of a Feather Work Together.
All righty, everyone. So this week, the career I chose I think this is going to be so simple. We'll see. Remember, after you hear the clues, make sure that you get on to our email address and send us your answers, because the winner receives a free ice cream cone here in Wayland, okay? So, here are the clues. This person works at a school. They love to sing or play an instrument. They start with a bachelor's degree, and then they go on and get their master's degree. They can work with students kindergarten through 12th grade, maybe even preschool kids. They give voice lessons or instrumental lessons. I don't know, guys.
Yeah.
Hopefully you have an answer. Be sure to send it in, okay? And now, also remember, 7th and 8th grade health students, you have a 30-day mental health challenge. Remember last week we were talking about how May is mental health week, or excuse me, mental health month. On the choice boards, you will find the challenges. So check out the ideas and how to take care of yourself. All right, over to Wax Wing.
So I'm going to tell you guys a little story. I've always wanted to learn to play the guitar. I always could see myself in the classroom just like playing my guitar and singing with the kids. And so my husband got me a guitar for Christmas. And during this quarantine day, I mean, I did send a little ditty to Miss York and, you know, laughed at it. But the other day I was like, okay, I'm going to seriously learn. And so I was looking up on YouTube to play chords and stuff. And so my left wrist, I've also broke it a couple times. So when I put the guitar down, like 10 minutes later, I was like, ah! Like, I couldn't move my wrist. So I'm too old. Like, I can't do it.
And it's hard. It's very hard. Yeah.
I was wondering if ukulele is easier.
Oh, yeah. Because they're smaller, but there's four strings. Yeah. Yep.
Yeah, I'm thinking I'm going to go for a ukulele, but then I'm like, who sits and plays their ukulele with their kids? I don't know.
People in Hawaii. Aloha.
There we go. So now, a little birdie told me that, Yellowhammer, you have a tip for Tuesday on Mental Health Month.
Yes, we do. We have a little tip because we want to keep things going. People are getting a little bit down because of this quarantine, and we're really getting sick of just sitting around, and we want to be out, but then we're a little nervous about it. So I just want to urge you to do a little bit more dancing in the house. A little thing you can do, put on your favorite music and dance it out and have a good time. No one has to see you. You can dance in your room, or you can dance with your family members, because we're dancing right now and we don't even have any music. Woo! Hey! So, it gets the stress out, too. You get all stressed out. Put on your favorite song, blast it. You got to blast it. And then just start moving around. It's going to make you feel better. So get your favorite songs on. Remember, dancers don't need wings to fly.
That's right. Have a great day.
All right. Dancing our music.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.